You are allowed to clap. It's okay. I know Lutherans don't do that sort of thing, but you are allowed. Bishop Warren used to be really good about that. He would, anytime something he felt like the Holy Spirit was working in, he'd say, get everybody to clap on it. So if you think the Spirit's working, clap. Have a ball. A couple of things this morning before we get started. Thank you, Ben, for that wonderful prelude and for playing for us this morning. Don't forget about the Fall Festival after worship. Dave's already boiling the brats and beer and getting ready to throw them on the grill, so hang around. Kat's preaching this morning for her first time, so be kind. I thought you wouldn't be. I just had to throw that in there. Also, remind you of Wednesday evening. This Wednesday evening at 6 here at First United is our monthly prayer service with Mount Zion, so come on out and join us for that. It's always a good time here. Is it there? Maybe it is. Here next time. That's right. I'm sorry. Thank you. I don't know what. I don't know. Forgive me. That is true. It is at Mount Zion because I remember Pastor saying he would not be there. They are traveling this week. Also, we need pictures of any veterans that you want to have on our slideshow for November the 6th. So we'll be remembering our veterans that day since Veterans Day is during the week. And also the diapers, y'all did good. Between us and Holy Trinity, we collected 20,000 plus diapers, which means that, yes, which means that between the two of us, our two churches, we met 20% of their goal this year.
Did we win?
Not too shabby, huh?
Did we win the competition?
No, they won. But I didn't expect us to win because, you know, they're bigger than us, and so I expected them to come in first. But really it was about the children, you know, and the diapers. So y'all did good. Thank you. Well, if we did that, we probably would have come in about even. So, because they're about three times bigger than us. Is there anything else this morning before we get started?
Charlie. Just a reminder, if I can step in here, we have a blood drive this Thursday.
Thursday?
From 12 to 6. We would love for you to walk up and just give blood. It's right here, of course, in our fellowship hall. There'll be food. There'll be T-shirts. And I think there's gift cards, but do it for the children. It's for Children's Health Care of Atlanta.
Indeed.
12 to 6.
Norm. Here. I want you to be conspicuous.
Good morning. We're going to talk briefly about some strategic planning. It's been a while since we've taken the survey. And we've gathered the results back, but I just want to kind of hit hit the fine points of the surveys to also say to pay attention to the graphs that will be on the survey. I'm holding this yellow folder and this little device right here that has become a part of everyday life. And so as a reminder for me that there are actually apps that churches are using today about their services, about what they're doing in the future, et cetera. So we're trying to keep up with them. Why do I mention that? Strategic planning. It can be tricky, right? But the participation part is the best way for us to know what the congregation is liking or wanting, and as well to understand just where we may be going in 5 years. Because if we don't do anything, we won't be anything, right? So I'll end it on this note, because I think question three was, if you recall the survey for those who took it, question three was a series of other questions. But I would say that that was the bulk, where's the strategic planning team at? That was the bulk of our discussion, so to speak, but because that question actually had about six or seven different answers that you could give to it. So if you answered that question and answered every one of them, that made that question about seven answers or seven questions long. Okay, hopefully that made sense. Well, certainly. was circle all reasons why you and possibly your family attend FULC. And then there was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 17 answers you can give. Okay? Did that answer your question on what question number 3 was? All right. So the other piece to that was, and it was a good question, and we got good feedback. I'm not saying that none of the questions that we didn't get good feedback from. It's just helping us to develop more questions for a couple more surveys that we're going to use, all for the spirit of pushing us forward in the world and making our church so that we have a plan. Okay? Questions? All right.
Thank you, Norm. Thank you. I'm fighting with my back today, so if I grunt, you'll know why. Anything else this morning? Our sermon hymn today has a call and response in it, so be paying attention to that as we go along. We have the response part. Charlie and the folks back there have the call part, so remember that. If there's nothing else, then let us rise as we begin. Oh my God. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Who is eager to forgive and who loves us beyond our days. Amen. My sisters and brothers, let us in the sight of God and all the hosts of heaven acknowledge our failure to love God and our neighbor as Jesus teaches us. God of mercy and forgiveness, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We continue to do harm to your good creation. We fail to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with you. Help us in our weakness to turn to you. By your Spirit, open our eyes to the path that leads to life. Be our refuge and strength on the journey through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Beloved of God, your sins are forgiven in the name of Jesus, our Redeemer. The Holy Spirit beckons us to new life in Christ who walks with us always. Live now in the confidence of God's abiding love through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Continue with our opening hymn, Jerusalem, My Happy Home. I have to go get my glasses.
There grows such sweet and pleasant.
Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Crown him with many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne. Hark how the heavenly anthem drops, all music but its own. Awake my soul and sing of him who died for thee. Through all eternity, crown him the Lord of love. Behold his hands and side, which wounds yet fills all full of love, in beauty glorified. No angels in the sky can fully bear that sight, but downward in their burning eyes, that mystery so bright. Grant him the Lord of years, the potentate of time, creator of the rolling spheres, ineffably sublime. All hail, Redeemer, hail, for thou hast died for me. Thy praise and glory shall not fail throughout eternity.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord God, tireless guardian of your people, you are always ready to hear our cries. Teach us to rely day and night on your care. Inspire us to seek your enduring justice for all this suffering world through Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading.
Thanks be to God. Lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come?
My help comes comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The Lord will not let your foot be moved, nor will the one who watches over you fall asleep. Behold, the keeper of Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will preserve you from all evil and will keep your life. The Lord will watch over your going out and your coming in from this time forth forevermore.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Hallelujah,
Praise to you, O Christ.
Can you turn on your mic? Mic's on. Sorry about that. New with the mic thing. I'm used to just using my loud mouth. Sir, y'all brother and sister? Excellent. So, do y'all annoy each other every now and then? Yeah? Just like poke at each other and aggravate each other every now and then? It's kind of what this widow was doing. A widow is a lady, no husband. Her husband died, and so she's all by herself, and she doesn't have anybody to help her. And so she was going to this judge, this man, to ask for some help, because she wasn't getting treated fairly. And he didn't really want to help her, but she was persistent. Do we know what persistent means? You just keep on trying. You keep on persevering. She might have aggravated him. She might have annoyed him. Just kept pushing at him and pushing those buttons until finally he said, "All right, fine. I give up. I will help you out." And the moral of this story is that is what we want to do with Jesus, is that we want to ask him for help and we want to be persistent. And maybe we want to pray so much that we annoy him. Really, we can't ever annoy Jesus. Jesus is just happy to have us talking to him. And the thought here is that Jesus will absolutely hear us and help us out and help us against people who are hurting us, because Jesus loves us no matter what. And I think we've got some little, and that's what we want you to remember, is that be persistent. Annoy Jesus with your needs just like you annoy your sister. Just do it, because Jesus loves you and Jesus will answer your prayers. Amen. Good morning. So I have my little cliff notes. I used to call this the seminarian version of the sermon, just to kind of give you some background. I know our bulletin gives us quite a bit, but just in case it wasn't enough, does anybody know what the meaning of the word Jacob means? I got to learn a big SAT word. Just as a background, I often teach campus ministry and middle schoolers. So a big word like usurps is really not in my list of things to say. But Jacob, also trickster, I think is what we tend to know of it as. But someone else described it as someone who seizes, circumvents, or usurps. Anybody watch The Handmaid's Tale, that series? You can raise your hand or don't raise your hand. The evil police were called the Sons of Jacob, which I thought was hysterical because they seized people and took them away, and sure enough, Jacob, the person who seizes. But anyway, I digress. So Jacob was left alone by himself. His family had gone on, and he was by himself. And I looked up this exact passage in the French Bible, and there was almost some terror going on, because it said, "Jacob remained alone." Dun, dun, dun. And so, obviously, he fought with God and was forever changed by the dislocation of his hip. It's one of my favorite passages, because that is giving us permission to fight and wrestle with God. It's perfectly okay. And sometimes we come from places where we're told that's not okay, but here it is, right in Genesis, right in my notes. And, you know, the thing that I really love about that is that because he fought with God and because he wrestled, he was forever changed. Now, I personally don't want my hip dislocated for fighting with God, but you just, you know, if you're Jacob, maybe that's what you needed. The Psalms passage, where does my help come from? My help comes before the Lord. That is just a minor glimpse of what God will do for us. And it is a beautiful, beautiful psalm. Randy, I think you said that was your favorite, one of your favorites. Yeah. Timothy. Sometimes some of these words in Timothy gets used against us, so I looked up a few words because it's the rebuking and the correcting and the teaching, and sometimes that gets a little interesting. But what I heard it say was be persistent, encourage. Rebuking is exposing errors of false teachers. As I joked this week, you know, correcting errors is like saying, is not admonishing or being rude to people or being ugly. It's saying, no, I think you're wrong. I think pineapple actually does belong on pizza. I think University of Tennessee is a better football team than the other SEC schools. I mean, that's rebuking and correcting. Correcting, interestingly enough, is only used one time in the New Testament, and it is in this particular passage, if you're interested in that kind of stuff. I like little nuggets like that. Giving instruction rebuking, but being a little bit more positive. Here's how you put pineapple on pizza. This is what it goes with. And then finally, getting to the passage itself, and I can finally put this thing down. Many interesting things in this. And of course, you know, our bulletin says, you know, if we are that persistent, or excuse me, if the judge was willing to yield to the widow who was very persistent, almost downright annoying, like a brother is to a sister, with the judge, imagine how God will answer our requests and our needs. And that is absolutely true. He will do that because we are his chosen people. Why are we his chosen people? Because we've been baptized. We are enough. We are loved by him. We are sealed by him forever. But something that came across to me as quite interesting too was, what if the widow was God? You know, we see it often as we should be the widow, we should be praying. Yes, yes, we should, and I'll get to that in a minute. But what if through baptism the widow was God? That God comes after us, and that God chases after us, and God doesn't give up on us, and God persists, and God loves us no matter what, and will chase us down in spite of ourselves. What if? Well, obviously, friends, it's not a what if. It's a fact. That is exactly what he does. But persistence is obviously the theme of the sermon, of the passages. Persistence, endurance, being consistent. And, you know, where is all this? Where is the good news in all this? How can I make it relevant to you? I had this great story about running a half marathon and Minnie Mouse carrying me across the finish line, but I have a better one for you. Friday, we started a little campus ministry. Probably unbeknownst to a lot of you, it happened at the 11th hour on Thursday night. It was a bit of a bluff calling, probably in some ways. And I showed up and we started working on our fledgling campus ministry at about 11:30. Did it go very well? No. No, it did not. I had the wrong name. I had come up with The Church Lot as the name of our campus ministry because that's exactly what this lot is called on the KSU Department of Transportation. Okay. I was like, is it a deer? Is it an alien? Oh my goodness. There's two? Wow. Okay, anyway. Meanwhile. Okay, so we went out there, Jerry and I went out there, 11:30. He pointed out that I had written the church stop instead of the church lot on everything, so I had to run in and change that real quick. And which also meant I had to change it on our Instagram. By the way, we have an Instagram account now. It's called The Church Lot, which before Jerry caught it was The Church Stop, so I fixed that as well. And, I mean, it was just a comedy of errors, but at the same time, you know, so part of me was thrilled that no one showed up on Friday. There were students in the parking lot that were actively avoiding me because it was like, oh, preacher person. And that's okay. I also learned on Fridays, no one goes to class. Either they don't have class or they just don't go. I would love that. I have a class on Friday. So we're going to try it tomorrow. But the good news is I have the coffee bought, I have the cups bought, I have all the creamer bought. Everything's ready to go. We're just going to try it again and I'm going to move it up. But as we said Thursday night, we got to draw the line in the sand somewhere. And we need to be persistent, and we need to be consistent. And we need to look at this project as a marathon, not as a sprint. KSU is not going to turn into Grace House overnight. It took 6.5 years to have 400 people show up at Grace House. I'm not saying that A, it's going to take 6.5 years here, or B, that there will be 400 people showing up. But this is a marathon. Our faith is a marathon. Why am I mentioning this? Because I want you to participate I want you to pray like this widow. Not only for that ministry, but for every ministry, for your family, for everyone. Be annoying to God constantly. Be annoying in your prayer to God, because God hears us. And I had a professor a long time ago say prayer is active participation in a miracle. And think about that. Think about that. Be persistent, because God is persistent with us. Thank God, God is persistent with us. Amen.
So this is the one that has the call and response. We've done it before. So when you get to the middle of the words, in parentheses will be the call, and I'll be handling that. And then you just echo it, hear from heaven even now. And then you just go, hear from heaven even now. And just sing along.
Turn from all our wicked ways, hear from heaven. into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In gratitude and humility, let us join together in prayer on behalf of all of God's creation. For all the baptized, that they become skilled in compassion and grace and equipped to share the good news with all. Grant your followers persistence in proclamation and prayer. Hear us, O God. For air and sky, clouds and sun, that they provide rain to parched land and relief to flooded ground. Renew and restore our polluted atmosphere and empower us to be worthy stewards of creation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For judges, juries, and all who work in the judicial system, that they desire wisdom, seek truth, rule with fairness, and have the courage to do what is right. Eliminate oppression and injustice in our criminal justice system. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For all who are lonely, especially those who have newly arrived in an unfamiliar city or country, political prisoners without recourse to justice, hospital patients without visitors, and any who are ill or grief-stricken, hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For those in our congregation and community engaged in advocacy work, with the persistence of the widow, they lift their voices in seeking justice on behalf of others. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of love, you bid us welcome the alien among us, and so we pray for the Q family, who we are helping to resettle in Clarkston. Bless and keep them as they learn to live in the American culture, and grant that they may thrive and be prosperous in their lives. Bless our volunteers and keep them safe in their travels as they selflessly give of their time and talents to assist this family in their journey. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You hear the cries of the people of Ukraine. Bless them with your healing presence and help us to do whatever we can to assist them in these their dark hours. Inspire our leaders to bring an end to this war. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Healing God, hear your people as we lift those in need up to you by name, out loud, or in our hearts. We pray for all who are on our prayer list. Visit them with your healing spirit. We pray for the faculty, staff, and students of Kennesaw State University as they continue their mission of education. And we pray for our sister congregation, Mount Zion AME Church. Bless and preserve them. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for our presiding Bishop Elizabeth and our Bishop Kevin. Bless them with your wisdom as they lead our church in these uncertain times. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of justice, the racial profiling of people of color and innocent victims of racist attacks continues to plague this nation. We are committed to condemning all forms of bigotry. Inspire us to make our actions as strong as our words. Lead us to advocate and be a voice for those whose voices have been taken from them. Help us to bring comfort, peace, and hope as we continue to struggle for justice for all of your children. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For those who have taught us faith and now rest in your heavenly peace, that we remember and give thanks for these saints who shared the gospel through word and deed. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. With grateful hearts, we commend our spoken and silent prayers to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share that peace among ourselves.
Father, we love you, we praise you, we
your great love, you richly provide for our needs. Make of these gifts a banquet of blessing, and make us ready to share with all in need, through Jesus Christ, who sets a table for all.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power, God of might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he. God, mighty Lord, gracious Father, endless is your mercy and eternal your reign. You have filled all creation with light and life. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. We praise you for the grace shown to your people in every age, the promise to Israel, the rescue from Egypt, the gift of the promised land, the words of the prophets, and at this end of all the ages, the gift of your Son, who proclaimed the good news in word and deed and was obedient to your will, even to giving his life. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is being given up for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is being shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, O God, with this bread and this cup, we remember the life our Lord offered for us. And believing the witness of his resurrection, we await his coming in power to share with us the great and promised feast. Send now, we pray, your Holy Spirit, that we who share in Christ's body and blood may live to the praise of your glory, and receive our inheritance with all your saints in light. Join our prayers with those of your servants of every time and every place, and unite them with the ceaseless petitions of our great high priest until he comes as victorious Lord of all. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now we're bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God who bears away the sin of the world. Thanks be to God.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace to eternal life.
Amen. Your turn. God of the abundant table, you have refreshed our hearts in the meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.